So what is Mealy and Moore machines? They are all finite automata with output. So finite automata is the simplest machine to recognize the patterns. The finite automata or the finite state machine is an abstract machine which has five elements or tuple. It has set of tuples, it has set of states and rules for moving from one state to another, but it depends upon the applied input symbol. Finite state machine is the simplest model of computation. It has a very limited memory. So there are, as we said, there are two types of machines with output, that is the Mealy machine and the Moore machine. So what is a Mealy machine? A Mealy machine is a finite state machine whose output depends on the present state as well as the present input. In Mealy machine, every transition for a particular input symbol has a fixed output. So for Mealy machine, we have six tuples. The Q, which is the finite state of finite set of states, the epsilon, which is the finite set of symbols with input called the input alphabet, the O, which is the finite set of symbols called the output alphabet, and delta, which is the input transition function, where delta implies Q cross epsilon gives Q, and the lambda is the output transition function, where lambda implies Q gives O. And Q0 is the initial state from where any input is processed. That is, Q0 belongs to Q. So here we can see there is an example of Mealy machine. So the question goes like this, that we have to design a Mealy machine where the input of a binary sequence says that there is a substring 101, and the machine, if there is a substring 101, the machine will produce an output A. If there is a substring 110, then it produces B. Otherwise, it throws the output C. So here, for the solution, we have made this, first we have made the partial diagram where the starting state is the Q0, which on input 1 goes to Q1 and produces output C. And similarly, Q1 on input 0 goes to Q2 giving output C, and Q2 on input 1 goes to Q3 giving output A. Here we are getting A because in the previous transitions, we are getting the output as 101, which is a desired output. And in the in the lower part of the diagram, from Q1, if we give the input 1 and we move to Q4, which gives the output C. And on Q4, which when it takes the input 0, it produces Q. It goes to Q5 and produces output B. And here we are getting B because in the previous transitions, we are getting 110 as the output. So here this partial diagram can be modified into a smaller diagram which has lesser number of states, because always a Mealy machine with a lesser number of states is always preferred. Okay, so now we are going to move on to the topic Moore machine. In Moore machine, the value of the output function depends on the present state only. Moore machine is described by six tuples as we described in the Mealy machine. So Moore machine also contains six tuples, that is Q, which is the finite set of non-empty set of states, the silent set of input alphabets, the delta set of output alphabets, the lambda output function mapping, which is Q to delta, and Q0 is as usual the initial state. So now we have come across an example of Moore machine. So here in the Moore machine, we said that the input the output is associated with the states. So we can see that all the outputs are written in the circles, which is for example, we can see that Q1, that is the output, is written beside Q0, which is the state. So here this is the Moore machine diagram, and this is the transition table for the Moore machine. So that's how the entire Moore machine has been solved. And here the input is 010, and the transition function delta is goes from Q0 to 0, or delta goes from Q1 to 1, and delta goes from Q0 to 0, producing the output Q2.
And here we have Mealy machine, the comparison of Mealy machine and Moore machine. In Mealy machine, output depends upon both upon the present state and the present input. And in Moore machine, the output depends only upon the present state. Generally, it has fewer state than Moore machine. In Moore machine, generally it has more state than Mealy machine. In Mealy machine, the value of the output function is a function of the transition and the changes when the input logic on the present state is done. In Moore machine, the value of the output function is a function of the current state and the changes at the clock edges whenever state changes occurs. In Moore machine, Mealy machine reacts faster to inputs. They generally react in the same clock cycle. In Moore machine, Moore logic is required to decode the output resulting in Moore circuit delays. They generally react on clock cycles later. We have conversion from Mealy machine to Moore machine. In Moore machine, the output is associated with every state. And in Mealy machine, the output is given along the edge with the input symbol. To convert Moore machine to Mealy machine, state output symbol are distributed to input symbol paths. But while converting the Mealy machine to Moore machine, we will create a separate state for every new output symbol, and according to incoming and outgoing edges are distributed. The following steps are used for converting Mealy machine to Moore machine. Step 1. For each state, Q1, calculate the number of different output that are available in the transition table of the Mealy machine. Step 2. Copy state Q1 if all the output of Qi are the same. Break Qi into the state as Qin. If it has n distinct outputs where n equals to 0, 1, and 2, and so on. And then the step 3, if the output of the initial state is 0, insert a new initial state at the starting which gives one output. And next we have the example. We have to convert this following Mealy machine into the equivalent Moore machine. We have the solution here, transition table of previous Mealy machine is as follows. First step, here comes the steps. For state Q1, there is only one indecent edge with output 0. So we don't need to split this state in Moore machine. For state Q2, there is two indecent edge with output 0 and 1. So we will split this state into two states, Q20 state will with output 0 and the Q21 with output 1. For state 3, for Q3, there is two indecent edges with output 0 and 1. So we will split this state into two state, Q30 state with output 0 and Q31 state with output 1. For state Q4, there is only one indecent edge with output 0, so we don't need to split this state in Moore machine. Next, we have the transition table for Moore machine will be like this, and the transition diagram for the Moore machine will be like this, where the Q1 state getting input 1 goes to Q20 and from Q0 and the out getting input A goes to Q1 and Q20 getting output A and B goes to Q4 and Q4 getting output B goes to Q1 and Q4 getting output A. Next slide. Next, we have conversion from Moore machine to Mealy machine. If the Moore machine, the output is associated with every state, and in the Mealy machine, the output is given along the edge with input symbol, the equivalence of the Moore machine and the Mealy machine means both the machine generated the same output string for the same input string. We cannot directly convert Moore machine to its equivalent Mealy machine because the length of the Moore machine is no longer than the Mealy machine for the given input. To convert Moore machine to Mealy machine, state output symbol are distributed into input symbol paths. We are going to use the following method to convert the Moore machine to Mealy machine methods. We have the methods. Let m equals to the six tuples here be the Moore machine, and the equivalent Mealy machine can be represented by m dash and the six tuples for m dash. The output function for is lambda dash can be obtained as follows.
Already discussed how to convert Moore machine to Mealy machine in earlier slide. So this is an example here. So this is the diagram of the Moore machine. Here this is given the transition table of the Moore machine. So Q is the state of the set of the states. So A, B and are the inputs, and the output is denoted by lambda. So in Q0 state, if we give the input A, it will go to Q0 state itself, and from Q0 state, if we give the input B, it will go to state Q1, and the corresponding output will be 0. And from Q1 state, if we give the input A, it will go to Q0 state, and if we give the input B, it will go to the state Q1 itself, and the corresponding output will be 1. So how we can convert the equivalent Mealy machine from the Moore machine? So we can use the previous method that Dipan has already suggested. So that is lambda dash of Q0 comma A equals to, we can write here lambda of delta of Q0 comma A. Here lambda dash is the output of the Mealy machine, and the lambda is the output of the Moore machine, and delta is the transition function of the Moore machine. So here we can write that we have already seen in transition table that from Q0 state, if we give input A, it will go to Q0 state itself. So we have written here lambda of Q0, and the corresponding output is 0, so which is equals to 0. Same for lambda dash of Q0 comma B equals to lambda of delta of Q0 comma B equals to, from Q0 state, if we give input B, it will go to Q1 state. It will go to Q1 state. So the output will be 1. For Q1 states, lambda of Q1 comma A equals to lambda of delta of Q1 comma A equals to lambda of Q0. Why? Because from Q1 state, if we give A input, it will go to Q0 state, and the output will be 0. So lambda dash of Q1 comma B equals to lambda of delta of Q1 comma B. So from Q1 state, if we give input B, it will go to Q1 state itself. So lambda of Q1, so which is equals to 1. So this is the following transition table of the Mealy machine. Q is the non-empty finite set of states, and sigma is the input. So here we can see for Q0 state, if we give input 0, the next state will be Q0, output will be 0. And for input 1, the next state will be Q1, and the output will be 1. In case of Q1 state, if we give input 0, the next state will be Q0, and the output will be 0. And if we the next state will be for input 1, the next state will be Q1, and the output will be 1. So in this way, from this transition table, we can draw this equivalent Mealy machine. So now we will discuss about the advantages and the disadvantages of the Mealy and Moore machines. So what are the advantages? That we all know that the Moore machines are cheap, and they are really very easy to use. And Moore machines are also very fast, and the Mealy machines are reactive, that is, they have a low response time, which means that they are also fast. So what are the disadvantages? That is, the Mealy machines are expensive for production, and its number of states can become unmanageable because there are too many states. What is the applications of Mealy and Moore machines? So the Mealy machines are used in processors because they have many states. And they are also used to provide a rudimentary mathematical model for cipher machines. And the Moore machines are used as a write enable in SRAM because they are really very fast. And they are also used in SRAM because SRAM needs a level sensitive control, which has signal to be asserted for an amount of time. Now, next next comes an example. So this is an finite state machine described here in the diagram, which is which has the starting state A. Okay, and here we have this, that the arc level is x by y, where x is stands for 1-bit input and y stands for 2-bit output. Okay, so here we have the four options. We have to find out the correct one. So let us explain it, how we can calculate it. So we assume that the input string to be 1101. So from a comma 1 to b comma 01, which is from state A, if we give the input 1, it will go to state B and the output will be 01. So here the previous input bit plus present input bit equals to 0 plus 1, which is the 01, which is the output. Okay. So now if from the state B, if we give the input 1, it will go to C state, so where the output is 10. Here also the previous input bit is 1 and the present input bit is 1, which is equals to 10, which is the output. Again, from C state, if we give the input 0, it will go to the state A, which has the output 0,01. So the previous input bit, which is 1, and the present input bit, which is 0, equals to 01, which will be the output. Again, we have come the first the state, which is the starting state A, where we can give the input 1, it will go to the state B, and the output will be 10. So the output will be 01. So from these four calculations, we can see that the option A is correct, which is the outputs, the sum of the present and the previous bits of the input, which we have already seen in the explanation. So thank you. We would like to conclude here our presentation. Sir, you are muted.
Oh, thank you. Very good presentation.